Good morning students. In the previous classes we have discussed about the chapter motion in a straight line. So in the chapter we discussed that how, what is the motion of a particle if it is moving along only one direction. So in that we have only one direction, means either it can move along positive axis or negative axis. So we have discussed if it is moving along positive x axis it has positive, and if it is moving in negative direction it considers negative. Now in this chapter I am going to discuss about, so this is a new chapter, that is the continuation of motion that in straight line. So this chapter we are going to discuss about what ma motion in a plane, means if a particle moves in a plane, means it can move in two dimensions or three dimensions, how we can represent the motion of particle. So to know that, we already discuss about the difference between scalar and a vector. What is a scalar? Any physical quantity which has only magnitude but no direction is called what? Scalar quantity. And if any physical quantity which has both magnitude and direction and should obeys one more function, that is vector laws of addition. If it obeys the vector laws of addition, then we can consider it is called what? Vector. It depends both on magnitude and direction. So in this chapter we are going to discuss about types of vectors that already have sent it in the above link. To easily understand the types of vectors, I forwarded a link to you. First watch that. Here this scalar depends upon what? Only magnitude but no direction. Now we already discussed types of vectors. Now let us begin. Here I am going to discuss only one vector, that is unit vector. What is a unit vector? So we said that, for example, a particle is moving in a plane, it is represented a point x, y, z, because it has displacement along x axis, y axis and z axis. So to represent this vector, whether the particle is moving along which direction, we taken a vector called unit vector. What is that? We call ma unit vector. So what is unit vector? Is a vector which has unit magnitude but specific direction. If any vector has unit magnitude and specific direction, that is called unit vector. So we can define the statement as a vector which has unit magnitude but specific direction is called unit vector. So how we can represent is, if a vector is represented by I cap, so this is the representation of unit vectors I cap. This represents that this is a unit vector having magnitude 1, and if any case it is represented by the particle I cap, this is moving along x axis. So this vector has magnitude 1, and if it is represented by I cap, means the particle is moving along x axis. Next one is j cap. J cap represents y axis. Next one is k cap. K cap represents that z axis. So each has special signification, right? If it is represented by I cap, it is called what? The particle is moving along x axis. If it is represented by j cap, it is moving along y axis. If it is represented by k cap, it is moving along z axis. For example, if vector is given by a bar is equals to 2 I cap plus 3 j cap, means the particle is moving in two dimensions, right? How many dimensions ma? two dimensions, that is along x-axis and y-axis. Along x-axis, what is its magnitude? 2. How can we say that? Because it is represented by I cap, the particle is moving along x-axis as well as y-axis. So, I cap represents the particle moving along x-axis, magnitude is 2. J cap represents that the particle is moving along y-axis and its magnitude is 3. So, this is the way to represent the unit vectors. For example, A bar is equals to 2i cap plus 3j cap minus 4k cap. So, means that, see here it has x, y, z. So, the particle is moving in 3 dimensions, that is x, y, z plane, magnitude 2 along x axis, magnitude 3 along y axis, magnitude minus 4 along z axis. So, from this, by seeing this, we can easily say that the particle is in moving in how many dimensions. So, here the important point is what? Unit vector. What is unit vector? A vector which has unit magnitude but specific direction is called what, ma? Unit vector. Okay. Now, I am going to derive the expression for resolution of a vector. Means we are saying that how the vector has been divided along x axis and y axis. Listen carefully, this is important concept. Resolution of a vector means a vector is resolved into two components. Simple ma. For example, assume that throw a ball into A. What happens? For example, have you seen the matches, cricket matches, right? A batsman hits the ball. The fielder at points take the ball and throws to the bowler. So, here what happens? When he throws the ball, the particle or the ball moves horizontal distance as well as it is traveling some height, vertical direction. So, here the vector, the ball is moving in two dimensions. Now, the components should move, divide along x-axis and y-axis, right? Yes. Assume that this is a vector, either it may be force, velocity or acceleration or any vector quantity. Let us assume that that is A bar. Now, it is moving, assume that it is moving in two dimensions. So, two dimensions means one along x-axis, another along y-axis. Okay, draw two perpendiculars. This is origin. Now, let us assume that the component along x-axis is ax, the component along y-axis is ay. Okay, the component of a along x-axis is considered as what? A suffix s, x. The component along y-axis of a is considered as what, ma? A suffix y. Let us assume that it is making an angle theta with x-axis. Now, I want to calculate ax and ay. Let us assume that this is one triangle OBC. Is a triangle. From triangle OBC, cos theta is equals to, cos theta is equals to what? This is a triangle, right? This is a triangle. Cos theta is equals to what, ma? Adjacent side by hypotenuse. What is hypotenuse here? A. Adjacent side is AX. So, I can write AX by A. That implies AX is equals to A cos theta. So, the component along X axis is equals to what? A cos theta. This is called what? Horizontal component. A vector horizontal component is what? Cos theta. Okay. Next, AY. What is AY? Let us see that. I want to calculate from the same triangle sin theta. Sin theta is equal to what, ma? AY by A. Why? Opposite sides are equal for a rectangle. So, this is AY, this is also AY. Now, from this, Ay is equals to A sin theta. This is equation number 2. So, here this is called horizontal component and this is called vertical component of a vector. And this is what? Vertical component. Now, I want to calculate the magnitude of vector, right?
Yes.
What we will do is take equation 1 square and 2 square. Means we are squaring this and adding these two. First square, ax square add plus ay square is equals to RHS side. A square cos square theta plus a square sin square theta. What is common? A square, right? Ax square plus ay square is equals to a square into cos square theta plus sin square theta. Cos square theta plus sin square theta equals to 1. That implies a square is equals to ax square plus ay square. This implies a is equals to root of ax square plus ay square. So, this is the magnitude of the resultant vector in 2 dimensions, or resolution of vector in 2 dimensions. Now, if you want to calculate angle theta, what is theta here only, right? Tan theta is equals to what, ma? Opposite side by adjacent side. Ay by Ax. Tan theta is equals to what? Ay by Ax. So, this is how a vector resolved into 2 components. In vector form, how we will write for 2 dimensions? The vector is divided into A is equals to Ax into I cap, means the component of x along x axis is Ax. To represent that is along x axis, we written Ai I cap plus Ay j cap. This is a vector representation and this is the magnitude of the vector. So, in this way, the vector is resolved into 2 components in how many dimensions, ma? 2 dimensions. We can ask the same question, how the vector is resolved into 3 components, right? 3 dimensions. Let us take same vector. It is moving in a plane. Has 3 components now. One is Ax, this is Ay, and this is Az. Let us assume that it makes an angle alpha with x axis, beta with y axis, gamma with z axis. The vector A is making an angle alpha with x axis, beta with y axis, gamma with z axis. Now, from the figure, cos alpha is equals to, cos alpha is equals to what? Adjacent side by hypotenuse. What is adjacent side by hypotenuse? Ax by A. Similarly, cos beta is equals to Ay by A, right? For cos beta, adjacent side is A by hypotenuse is A. Next, last one, cos gamma is equals to, say this is gamma, adjacent side is Ay, hypotenuse is A. So, you can write Ay by, sorry, Az by A. What we will do? Adding these 3 equations, what you can do here? Cos square alpha plus cos square beta plus cos square gamma. What we are doing here? 1 square plus 2 square plus 3 square. Cos square alpha plus cos square beta plus cos square gamma is equals to ax square by a square plus ay square by a square plus az square by a square. Send a square there or keep here only. What happens now? Cos square alpha plus cos square beta plus cos square gamma is equals to what, ma? ए एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस ए वाई स्क्वायर प्लस ए जेड स्क्वायर बाय ए स्क्वायर. वी नो वेरी वेल अकॉर्डिंग टू कोसाइन रूल व्हाट अकॉर्डिंग टू कोसाइन रूल cos square alpha plus cos square beta plus cos square gamma is equals to 1. Substitute that we get a square is equals to ax square plus ay square plus az square. That implies what ma? A is equals to root of ax square plus ay square plus az square. Have you observed? In two dimensions we got a is equals to root of ax square plus ay square plus a square, sorry, ay square. Now in three dimensions it becomes what ma? Ax square plus ay square plus az square. Ax is the coefficient of magnitude of vector along x axis, ay is the magnitude of vector along y axis, the magnitude of vector along z axis is what? Az. So in vector form the same can be written as what? Ax into I cap plus Ay into Z cap plus Az into K cap. So this is the way a vector is resolved into two components or three components. From all this we consider what? If it is in two dimensions, how we can write? In two dimensions a vector can be represented as Ax I cap plus Ay J cap. What is I cap? Represent that the vector has component along x axis, J cap represent along z axis, sorry, y axis. What about the magnitude? Magnitude is represented by modulus. This is called what? Modulus of A is equals to root of, we are not going to consider this one, what you can get ma? Ax square plus Ay square. Similarly, in three dimensions, in three dimensions what you can write? A is equals to ax I cap plus ay z cap plus az k cap. The magnitude is equals to what? Root of ax square plus ay square plus az square. So this is how a vector is resolved into two components and three components. You just go through these two videos what I forwarded now. Here we can discuss types of vectors and how these vectors are inculcated in this chapter easily. Okay, thank you students.